Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. Put your right hand over your heart. Ready, begin.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, Dons. I'm Catherine.
And I'm Anushka. Today is Wednesday, January 13th, 2021.
And you're watching CHTV.
I'm kind of nervous for finals next week.
Yeah, me too. I should really start studying.
Yeah, you definitely should.
Hey, that means we're almost done with half of the school year. Finally. That went by so much slower than I thought it would.
Well, good luck on your finals next week, everyone. Now, let's head into this week's announcements.
Seniors, please join the counseling team and attend the senior drop-in to discuss pseudos complete, mid-year transcripts, next steps, etc.
The Dons attended the Surf City Model UN Conference this weekend. The Dons won the gavel in half the committees. Amia Dawis, Azalea Han, Kaya Gupta, Taya Poblet, Naima Delawar, Brian Koo, Joshua So, Kelly Fernandez, Krishma Patel, Neha Lala, and Anjali Mani took the top awards home this weekend. Incredible job, Dons.
The Math Mentorship Program is opening slots for second semester. If you are a freshman or sophomore who has a C or below in math, take this opportunity to sign up to get tutored once a week. Students from last semester have said that it's great to have consistent homework help, and they have seen overall improvement. Please register by Tuesday, January 19th on the Our Power website, tinyurl.com/chshourpower.
Now let's head into this week's segments.
Hi, I'm Narn.
And I'm Julian, and welcome to the first episode of Sports Desk.
Since we don't have any sports at school at the moment, we're going to be covering everything that's been happening in professional sports so far.
So here's everything that is happening in sports for January.
Let's roll.
Nobody pray for me. It been a day for me. Yeah, yeah.
Hey, I remember syrup sandwiches and crime allowances. Vanessa Nickel with some counterfeits, but now I'm counting this. Parmesan with my accountant lives in.
After the conclusion of the 2019-2020 NBA season in October, the 2020-2021 NBA regular season started on December 22nd, 2020. As a result of the late start, the NBA season was shortened to 72 games, rather than the typical 82 games of an NBA regular season. The playoffs will also start at a later date, as they are scheduled to start on May 18th. Our home teams, the LA Lakers and LA Clippers, as of January 10th, currently sit at 8-3 and 7-4 respectively. There have already been reports of a COVID-19 outbreak amongst NBA players, as more and more players are testing positive for the virus. Several players have already been ruled out of games, while some games have been postponed. Despite this, however, the NBA is currently not planning to shut down the league as they did back in March.
Also, the NFL has started their playoffs. Last week, they just finished their wildcard rounds. The Bills won against the Colts 27-24. The Rams won against the Seahawks 30-20. The Buccaneers won against the Washington football team 31-23. The Ravens won against the Titans 20-13. The Saints won against the Bears 21-9. And not last but not least, the Browns won against the Steelers 48-37, with only 3 interceptions in the first quarter. This week, the divisional round is going to be taking place. The Rams are going to go against the Packers on Saturday. The Ravens are going to go against the Bills. And then on Sunday, the Browns would be going against the Chiefs, and the Buccaneers will be going against the Saints.
This is the end of the sports segment for this week.
This is Narn.
This is Julian.
We'll see you guys later.
Like I never felt no pain, even if it don't go my way. change it at all. I call this part the beginning, I've been starting the ball. Even though the price is high, I look at it like it's low. Cause every time I check my bank account, I'm never close to O. Remember those days when we used to get no pay. Now we sipping champagne when we thirsty. Gotta do it big once you finally get the chance. When you come from the bottom, everything gets enhanced. Watch me do the money dance. Before I perform, need my money in advance. They said I'd be nothing. Ain't the shame now. Look at the boy, he deserves everything. All the fame, all the game. Cause he took all that pain, turned it into something different. Now they asking what's his name, where he from, where he playing. Yeah, we gon' need to know. Cause Tevin stay poppin' and he kills it with the flow. Yo,
I've been rolling around the city like I got it made. Spending all my money like chump change. Living every day like Friday. Wouldn't change it for the world.
Nah.
I've been rolling around my city like I'm in a rage. Smiling like I never felt no pain.
Nope.
Even if it don't go my way, I wouldn't change it for
the world. Hey everyone!
Hello, Ms. Yamashita's ceramics class recently had an assignment to create a unique mask. It could have been campy, had a message, be upcycled, serious, or even been a political statement.
Here is one of the excellent designs one of her students made.
Hi, my name is Taviana Woods. I am a freshman at Cerritos High. This is my mask that I made for the project Miss Yamashita assigned.
What's the message behind your mask?
The message and the meaning behind this mask is the acronym BLM, which stands for Black Lives Matter, as many of you guys may already know. Issues with racism have been around for the longest. But in 2020, the conversation just became a much bigger one after the innocent life of George Floyd was taken, and it was video recorded in such broad daylight, and it just made a lot of people wake up and be like, wow, this is a reality for people of color.
What compelled you to share this message?
You know, Black lives are innocently taken every day, and at the hands of police brutality just because of the color of our skin. And that's what really compelled me to make this message, because to me that's really sad that just because we have a different shade of skin color, we are killed because of that. Like I said in my original presentation, Black Lives Matter doesn't mean that other lives don't. It simply just means that right now Black voices are the ones that need to be uplifted and amplified, because our voices haven't been heard for the last 400 plus years. And no matter how many people want to say that we've progressed and come farther than where we were back then, we really haven't. Because Breonna Taylor, Rashard Brooks, Daniel Prude, Stephen Clark, and just so many others are examples that it definitely still does. So I hope this message resonates with you and you think about this throughout the rest of your day. Have a good day and goodbye.
Thank you so much for sharing your wonderful message.
See you next time on CHTV.
Hello everyone, I'm Hayden, this is CHTV, and today I'm going to teach you guys how to work out, and this is going to be a three-part series. One is going to be upper body, and the second series is going to be more ab focusing, and the third part is going to be more legs. And this is CHTV and New Year's resolutions. A lot of you guys are trying to work out, so I'm gonna try to teach you guys so that way you guys don't injure yourselves while doing that. So yeah, let's get started. So a good start in working out is, first, obviously you have to stretch. So obviously you wanna stretch out your arms, you wanna stretch out your whole body before you do this workout. And So what I like to do when I work out is, after I'm done stretching, I like to work on my forearms first, my biceps, my triceps, and then my shoulder area after that. For forearms, what I like to do is I carry dumbbells and I walk around, and then you'll get a nice grip on it so that way your forearms get a good workout in and you'll really start feeling the burn after a few minutes. Next, I would like to work on my bicep area, and what I like to do is I like to curl dumbbells. If you use your momentum to lift it, you won't be focusing on the bicep as much, and then you'll lose the actual workout by pulling in like that instead of just focusing on the bicep itself. Next, I would like to work on my triceps, and this muscle is underrated. A lot of people forget to focus on the tricep area. And what you do is you go down and you pull like this, and you'll get a good workout. Another thing you could do, hold it up like this and start lifting it up. You'll get a really good workout in. Now for your shoulders, what you wanna do is, there are three parts of the shoulder. There's the front, there's the medium, and then there's the back shoulder. So for the front, you wanna grab the dumbbells and you wanna lift it up like this. And then you just keep doing that, and then that'll get a good front shoulder part. Now for the middle part of your shoulder, you just do normal flies. That'll get a good workout on your shoulders, and try to focus on your shoulders as much and not your momentum. And lastly, for the back part of your shoulders, what you wanna do is you wanna go down, have a straight back, and lift the dumbbells up, and you'll really start feeling your back shoulders moving, and you'll feel your shoulders get better and stronger. Now, as you can see, all these workouts you can do at home. You don't need any outside equipment. You could use all these dumbbells. You could get them on Amazon. They're really simple. You could do them at home, and it doesn't take much more than your body weight and your arms. And yeah, what I like to do to finish all of this off is by doing as many push-ups as I can until I can't do it anymore. I like to push myself to the max so that way I can improve. Keep in mind, after doing these arm workouts, you could do it multiple times and just repeat this cycle until you really start to feel that burn. And yeah, make sure you're eating healthy, make sure you guys are drinking a lot of water and staying healthy during quarantine. And yeah, this is CHTV, and I'm Hayden, and I'll see you guys in part two.
Hello Dons, this is Sean, and in today's segment, we'll be discussing the U.S. victory in the IIHF World Junior Championship. The International Ice Hockey Federation, or better known as the IIHF, is responsible for organizing this annual event where national ice hockey teams from around the world, consisting of players under the age of 20, face off for a chance at gold. The championship is traditionally held in late December and ends in early January. The 2021 IIHF World Junior Championship ended last week on January 5th, with Team USA taking home the gold medal. The last time that the U.S. national junior team won gold was in 2017. However, this is only their fifth gold medal compared to Canada's 18. Canada loves their hockey and is very good at it, which is why the fashion that Canada went down this year was an upset. Canada had entered the gold medal game with back-to-back shutouts over the course of 6 games and had only allowed 4 goals to score. They also hadn't trailed at any point in the tournament before this game. All of these factors made Canada seem like the expected winner. However, when the final buzzer sounded, it was Team USA with a 2-0 win. This shutout win from the US is the reason why this year's gold medal game was an upset. Sure, Team USA was performing well in the tournament, but no team seemed more poised to win than Canada did. This win gave USA Hockey its fourth consecutive victory over Canada in a World Junior Championship final, making the rivalry between these two teams all the better. Well, there we have it. I hope that you have learned a thing or two from this video and have found it interesting.
That's it for today, Dons.
Thanks for tuning in to CHTV.
We wish all of you a
wonderful Wednesday.